us pray. Matchless and eternal, righteous, holy God, Father God, we come before you one more time, O God, and we just give you praise and we give you glory and we give you adoration, O God, and we worship you because there is no other God like you, O God. You're the true and living God, and you're worthy to be praised, O God. I come before you, O God, humbly as dust and as ashes, O God, knowing that only you alone should be glorified, O God. Father God, let your word be glorified today, O God. Let your name, O God, be glorified. Let your word go forth without hindrance, O God. We give you all the praise and we give you all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen and amen. We give God the praise and the glory, and we honor our God because our God is worthy. Yes. He is so worthy to be praised. The spoken word this morning is, God is your shield and every death agent is canceled. Amen. And when I got that word from God, I was like, but you know what God has been showing me is that he is indeed our shield. He is our refuge. He is our strength. He is our fortress. And everything that the enemy sends, because the enemy has released some death agents after children of God. In Revelation 12, it told us that when the war broke out in heaven and the devil was dispatched to earth, that the word of God said that he has declared war on all those who have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. So children of God cannot just relax because the devil has sent some death agents after children of God. Whether it's death agents to steal our peace, to steal our joy, to steal the worship of God, to steal our health, our finances, you name it. There are so many death agents that have been released. But I give God the praise and the glory that he has said that he is our shield and that Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life. So what does that mean for us? That every death agent that comes against a child of God is canceled in the name of Jesus and by the blood of Jesus Christ. So I'm excited this morning. I'm excited this morning. I know that there are death agents that the angel, that the devil has sent against me and has sent against my household and your homes. But God is here to tell you this morning that he is our shield and every death agent is canceled. This morning we read in the word, and I'm going to go into the word of God to show you that this is so. The first lesson we read this morning was in Daniel 6. And the word, we know that the story of Daniel 6, that Daniel was a child of God who was held in captivity in Babylon. But even though he was in captivity, God elevated him in the midst of his enemies and was blessing him even in captivity. The devil didn't like that, you see. So he decided to send a death agent after Daniel to say that, look, we can't find any issues with him, but I know if we tell him that he can't worship his God, that he won't be able to do that. And the word of God said the decree came, and the word of God, when Daniel heard it, he went into his upper room and opened his windows. And the word of God, he set his eye to Jerusalem and he worshiped God, as it was his custom. You see, when the devil sends us death agents, that's what we need to do. We need to go on our knees and pray to God, because God has already canceled it. Yes. God has already canceled it. But you have to decree it and believe that it is already canceled. So the word of God said when they saw Daniel, they're like, ah, we got him. And I love the word when it said that. The King Darius, when he put him in the tomb, in the lion's den, and they sealed it, that it cannot be altered or changed. I love when man think that when certain death agents come at you, that it's final, and they have the final say. But I give God the praise and the glory that every death agent is canceled in the name of Jesus Christ. And the word of God said they threw Daniel in the den of the lions. My God. And they set him in the dens of the lion. But guess what? Hungry lions. That they thought that has this man's body hit the bottom, that he would be ripped into pieces. But the word of God testifies. I wonder why Darius went there the next morning.
Darius, a pagan king, who thought that his signet ring that sealed this, that it was final, then why was he going to the den of lions to seek for a man to be alive? Oh, my Lord, I give God the praise and the glory that whatever death agent the enemy sent, he doesn't have the final say. I give God the praise and the glory that Jesus Christ has conquered on our behalf and has given us the power and the authority to step on every death agent in the name of Jesus Christ, because Jesus has conquered it all for us. Everything is under the feet of Jesus Christ. And because we are in the body of Jesus Christ, guess what? Everything is under our feet. So we're going to stand victoriously and declare the word of our God and let every death agent know it has to take its flight in the name of Jesus Christ. My Lord, the word of God said when Darius went to the tomb, he said, Daniel, servant of the Most High God, has your God been able to deliver you, my God, out of the hand, out of the paws of the lion? And I love what the word of God said, that Daniel said, yes, O king, my God sent his angel and shut the lion's mouth so that they have not hurt me, because I was found innocent before him. And also, O king, I have done no wrong before you, my Lord, my God. And the king ordered that Daniel be taken out of the lion's den. Oh, Lord, we give God the praise.
Amen.
A death agent sent from the pits of hell to kill this man, to take this prophet of God out by lions. But God said, I am your shield. My Lord, I am your protector. I am your deliverer. It doesn't matter if I am for you, who can be against you? The word of God said that those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion that cannot be removed but abides forever. When Daniel heard the decree, he didn't quiver because he knew the God that he served. And he believed that the God who spoke all things into existence could deliver him from the den of the lions. And it was so because God showed up with a mighty way. You see, this heritage that I'm talking about, it's only for children of God. Children who have acknowledged that there is a God. Those who have accepted the saving grace of Jesus Christ. Because the enemies of Daniel, who didn't know who God is, the word of God said their bodies didn't even touch the pit before the lions overpowered against them. So this shield that God has, it's for his people. It's for those who the enemy is raging war against. My God, he comes at you to steal your peace, a peace that he didn't give us. The word of God said, Jesus said in John 14, 27, peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give you peace. Let not your heart be troubled. The enemy is trying to steal our peace. He brings situations in our lives to put death our peace so we can't worship God the way we ought to worship him. He comes and he steals our joys with problems. Problems after problems everywhere you look to rob you of your joy. But the word of God said, weeping may endure for the night, but joy coming in the morning. And I'm giving God praise, and he comes at your health. That agent of death for your health. Everywhere you look, people are coming up with all different kind of health issues because that death agent has been released to come against God's people with different health issues. But as the word of God says in Isaiah 53:5, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, hallelujah, by his stripes, oh, glory be to God. Oh, glory be to God. By his stripes, we are healed. Every death agent is canceled in the name of Jesus. No matter how it looks and no matter how they come, they are canceled in the name of Jesus Christ. And we have to believe it because the word of God has just testified that when that death agent agent came against Daniel, that God showed up in a mighty way and delivered him out of the power of the lions.
Amen.
And why is this? Why is it that every death agent is canceled? Because in Revelation 1, when John was getting a revelation and he saw Jesus Christ, what did he say? Jesus says, I am he who lives and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And I have the keys of Hades and of death. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, has the keys to death and Hades. So guess what? No, every dead agent is in the palm of Jesus Christ. And we are joint heirs with Jesus Christ. So guess what? Every dead agent is canceled. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Glory. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. We give God the praise and the glory. We give God the praise and the glory. Because Jesus said it, that I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me, he shall never see death. Do you believe this? My God, the word of God in Psalm 118:17 said, I shall not die, but live, and to declare the works of the Lord. Oh, saints of God, you ought to be excited this morning. Saints of God, you must be rejoicing that no matter what form these dead agents take, no matter how they come, my God, they are canceled in the name of Jesus and by the blood of Jesus Christ. When he comes against your finances, there's a dead agent that is for your finances. Finances, where you can't pay your bills, you don't know how you're going to eat. But what the word of God says in Psalm 37:25, I have been young and now I'm old, yet have I ever seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. Listen, death agents have no authority of children of God. And you have to, when you see them coming, you speak it. Oh, glory be to God. Oh, you gotta speak it. The word of God in Proverbs 18:21 says, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat of its fruit. You gotta speak against things. Oh, you gotta say, I decree and declare that my family and my finances, that the death agents are coming against, are canceled in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, death agent of health issues is canceled in the name of Jesus Christ. You gotta decree it and declare it and let the devil know that you know the authority that Jesus Christ has transferred into your hand.
Amen.
You gotta speak with authority because we have the authority through Jesus Christ to look these dead agents in the face and tell them that they are canceled by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Oh, glory be to God.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, glory, glory, glory. Oh, we give God the praise and the glory. Oh, the devil is a liar. Yes, he's a liar and a defeated foe. And all he comes to do is to rob, steal, and destroy. But I give God the praise and the glory that we have a shield. We have a God. We have a protector who will never leave us or forsake us, who is constantly watching over us. As we read this morning in Psalm 91:1, it says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty God. That is the heritage of those who love the Lord. When God was calling Abraham, he said, behold, I am your God, your shield, your everlasting, exceeding reward. That is the God that we serve. And we have to give our God a praise. Can we give our God a praise in this place this morning? Can we give our God a praise in this place this morning? Oh, we read a word about our brother Lazarus. My God, that the devil sent a health death agent. Oh, after our brother Lazarus. And I love when the word of God said that
When Jesus heard that Lazarus was sick, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God.
Oh, glory! Sometimes we're near to death in our eyes, but I'm here to tell you that it is not death, but it's for God to get the glory from this situation. Sometimes our situations may get rugged. It might look hopeless, but Jesus has said, oh, this death agent is not unto death, but it is for the glory of God, because every death agent is canceled in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh my God, I'm so excited this morning. I am so excited to know that God is in total control, and that no matter what the enemy brings at us, it is canceled in the name of Jesus Christ. Then the word of God said that when Jesus finally came to where Lazarus was, that he was dead for 4 days. And the onlookers were like, couldn't this man who healed the sick and gave sight to the blind, couldn't this same man prevent this man from dying? But you see what I love about God? God specializes in the impossible. What I love about God is when he does things, the minds of humanity is always baffled, and God will always get the glory. Because if Jesus has just healed him, it wouldn't have been the same. It wouldn't have been the same.
Right.
It wouldn't have had the same impact. So God will allow the situation to get close to death, that people think, oh, there is no hope and there is a stench. Because he's been, but it's because when God shows up and does the impossible, even unbelievers have to give God praise.
Yes,
even those who are doubting have to give God the glory.
Because
this is something that is far impossible. So this is why Jesus couldn't just heal him. Because it wouldn't have the same effect.
Yes.
It wouldn't have the same effect if it was just healed. All it would have just been one of the normal miracles. But you see, when God allows your situation to get to the place where everybody said, there's no coming back from this. There's no hope in this. There's nothing that is going to come with life from this. I'm here to tell you that God said he specializes in the impossible.
Yes.
Is there anything too hard
for
Jehovah God to do? Oh, glory, hallelujah. I give God the praise.
Amen.
Oh, that when man is saying this and no, God is saying yes. And the word of God said that Mary and Martha, Mary was like, but yes, God, we believe. And Jesus told her who he is. You see, that's the thing. Whenever Jesus shows up, it's life. Anywhere Jesus is, life, death has to give way to life, because Jesus is life.
Yes,
so when your situation looks like death, you call on he who is life, which is Jesus Christ. And he can transform your situation that looks hopeless and look like it's ready to be buried, and he can bring life to it. That is the God we serve. That is the heritage that we have through Jesus Christ. And the word of God said when Jesus got to the tomb, they're telling him, oh, you know, there's a stench. He's been there for so long. And Jesus said, roll away the stone. Oh, the devil liked to trap us into places and seal us in. He tried to seal Daniel in the lion's den. He tried to seal Lazarus. And ultimately, he tried to seal Jesus. But I give God the praise and the glory that nothing can separate us from the love of God who is in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Nothing, no death agent that the enemy sends. The word of God said we are more than conquerors. Oh, you got to believe the word of God. You got to speak the word of God in your situation. When the enemy raises up like a flood, the word of God said that, oh, the Lord said that he raised a standard against him. So when the devil comes at you, you got to speak the word with the authority. You got to speak it. You got to speak it and let him know he has no authority.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory be to God.
Yes.
No authority over a child of God. No authority over the child of God. No authority. authority over the child of God. The word of God said, if God is for us,
who
can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him for us all, won't he freely? Oh, put those death agents and cancel them and send them back to hell. That is what God does for his people.
Hallelujah.
So here was Lazarus, bounded in a tomb for 4 days. How the word of God said he had a stench because rigor mortis was setting in. Oh, oh, glory be to your name. But when Jesus Christ showed up on the scene and he said, Lazarus, come forth. My God, the word of God said the man who the world thought was dead for 4 days with a stench came forth. And Jesus said, loose him and let him go. I'm here to tell you that the dead agents, you have authority to speak to God, to loose them and release the blessing and the victory in your name into your life. That's the God that we serve.
Amen.
That is the heritage that we have.
Hallelujah.
And you have to believe it and receive it and operate in it.
Yes.
Because God is our shield.
Oh, yes.
God said that every death agent that comes against a child of God is canceled in the name of Jesus Christ and by the blood of Jesus Christ. The word of God in 1 Corinthians 15:55, it says, oh death, where's your sting? Oh Hades, where's your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. God is your shield.
Yes.
Oh, glory be to your name. God is our shield. So it doesn't matter what the death agents are that the devil has released against us. Because I'm here to tell you, he has released them. Oh, he has released them. It's only a matter of time before you come up against them. But I'm telling you that if you are carrying about the testimony of Jesus Christ, the enemy has declared war on you. And when you're in war, there are weapons that are going to come against you. And I'm here to tell you that there are some death agents that will be coming against you. Oh, but hold on to the Lord God. Hold on to the victory that we have in Jesus Christ, that he said he disarmed principalities and powers and make a public spectacle of them by triumphing over them. They are under Jesus' feet, and therefore they're under our feet. So you get ready for them and be ready to stand and speak life in your situation. Speak life.
Yes.
Speak life.
Yes.
Oh, in the midst of death.
Hallelujah.
Speak life in the midst of uncertainty. Speak hope. Speak life. Because Jesus Christ has already conquered on our behalf.
Yes.
And the devil in hell doesn't like it. So he has dispelled some death agents. But I'm excited. Oh, I'm excited because the word of God says that as the mountain surrounds Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. So I'm excited to know that no matter what the death agent may come, I'm victorious.
Amen.
I am victorious in Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
And you got to hold on to that, saints of God.
Praise the Lord.
You got to hold on to that. You got to believe that with all your heart. You got to receive it. You got to speak it. And you got to live it. Because the battle is the Lord's. And we've already gotten the victory. For I am persuaded. And I will end with this scripture. Romans 8:38-39. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Father God, we give you all the praise and we give you all the glory, Lord. And we honor you as Jehovah God. Heavenly Father, let your children receive your word, O God. And let them know, O God, that you are for us. And because you are for us, no one or nothing can be against us, O God. And we're going to stand in the victory that was accomplished for us over 2,000 years ago on Calvary's cross. Father God, we give you all the praise and we give you all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And amen. Amen. Praise amen. The Lord.
Amen.
To God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God
amen.
Be the glory. Great things he has done.
Jesus.
Only give God the praise.
Hallelujah.